Weather with Chief Meteorologist Michael Coates.
Outside, but the biggest problem, it's really been the wind. That's been bugging us all day long. So it's taken us what would normally be a great day just to an average day because of those nasty wind speeds. Now, I got good news for you. As we head into the weekend, we're going to keep temperatures into the lower to mid-80s, not blazing hot. However, we still have more wind to deal with tomorrow, and then things really begin to heat up on Father's Day this Sunday. 70 degrees right now, looking live to the Farm Bureau cam in Pocatello, and we have fairly clear conditions with winds at 10 miles an hour. Idaho Falls also into the 60s and 70s right now with winds west at 13 miles an hour. You get the occasional wind gusts into the 20s and 30s, and we're going to have that wind off and on for much of tonight, but not as strong as what we were picking up just a few hours ago. And we got a couple thunderstorms in the neighborhood, and you'll notice that they're just passing through from Montana. With this Montana system here passing through, we picked up a little bit of wind. We've had a weak cold front come through, and we're looking for more thunderstorms to really plague the same spot. Eastern Idaho and western Wyoming, we're going to get a few thunderstorms just passing through to the mountains. This is what's happening. High pressure along the California coastline. It's pumping in the heat from the south. You look to the north, though, on the opposite end of the jet stream, you got an area of low pressure over Canada, British Columbia. That's going to drag some moisture and cooler air to the north of us. We're just on the edge of that. That's why we pick up some wind, and that's why we're going to see a few thunderstorms making their way near into the region. But we're not looking for a lot of moisture as we get into your Friday and Saturday. So if you're going to be going to the mountains, I'll show you that Vipercast in just a second. But already by lunchtime tomorrow, once again, temperatures hitting the lower 80s, mid-80s for tomorrow afternoon across the Snake River Plain with some clouds in the afternoon. Let me show you why. 10 o'clock tonight, the thunderstorms in Montana are clearing out. A beautiful start for tomorrow morning. Then by the afternoon and evening hours, 7 o'clock, thunderstorms, once again, that same pocket right around the Continental Divide, Island Park there near the border of West Yellowstone. We'll see a few thunderstorms trying to work in. Sunday, once again, gorgeous in the morning, but it's going to be hotter on Sunday. Highs pushing around 90 degrees for Sunday. A few thunderstorms trying to work in through southwestern Montana. And then once again on Monday, guess what? We're going to get more thunderstorms in the same exact location. For the rest of us here, sunny, hot, and windy as we go through the rest of the 8-day forecast with temperatures tomorrow at 82 for Blackfoot, 85 in Pocatello, and 81 for Idaho Falls. Rigby, you're looking at 80 and 85 for Burley. With the upper 70s in Mackey, we'll hit the lower 80s in Chalice, upper 70s in Salmon. Rexburg, you're hitting also the upper 70s with the mid-70s in Jackson Hole. Same for Driggs and Ashton with the lower 70s in Island Park. Around Bear Lake, highs near 80, 84 for Lava Hot Springs, and 86 in Malad. With the 8-day forecast showing us the temperatures really perking back up here just in time for your Father's Day. Also backing off to lighter levels, the wind just a bit there for your Sunday. Lower to mid-80s here into Monday and Tuesday, more wind to get us into next week, and you'll see temperatures staying pretty hot heading into next weekend. Upper 80s and lower 90s taking us to the end of the 8-day forecast towards next Saturday. Pocatello, temps here pushing around 91 for Sunday afternoon. Monday, we're bringing in the highs into the mid to upper 80s, and we'll carry in the wind, quite a bit of wind, all across the region. Rexburg, you're going to be looking at highs here. Pretty warm for the weekend. 79 for tomorrow, 84 on Sunday. Lower 80s Monday and Tuesday. Lots of sunshine for the rest of the week there with highs pushing near 90. Blackfoot, temps here around 87 for Sunday. Father's Day, that's going to be pretty hot there. We're going to be looking at mid-80s after the Father's Day, and then we're going to be looking at mid to upper 80s all throughout next week with the lower 90s into next weekend. Salmon, I showed you a couple thunderstorms on the Vipercast, but even then, the risk of seeing thunderstorms in Salmon in town pretty low. We're going to be looking at highs here pushing into the upper 70s to mid-80s. That's this weekend with some windy conditions on Monday. So you're going to have a few thunderclouds trying to get into Salmon, but the risk is still fairly low. Jackson Hole and the National Park, 74 for tomorrow. Upper 70s on Sunday, 80s into Jackson next week. That also goes for Island Park. But you'll notice that I was showing that the thunderstorms really like to hit right through Henry's Lake, West Yellowstone,
yeah,
National Parks. That's where it's going to be all weekend long. So if you go out there for Father's Day, just you could see a couple thunderstorms. At this point, nothing major, nothing
pretty
severe.
Nice for the most part.
Yeah. And typical, yeah. Normal. But it's going to be above normal temperature-wise for Sunday. I mean, we're pushing to 90.
Yeah, there's something about the topography there that makes it rain in that area a lot, doesn't it?
It does, and it's just a lot of times where the moisture's coming in here from the northwest. But everybody's going to be hot. Everybody's going to be sunny for the most part. And we may even see some temperature records broken this weekend.
All right. Thank you, Michael. Idaho Falls is being called one of the most playful cities in America. We'll take a look at why next.
Get First Alert weather anytime, on demand. Log on to localnews8.com.